Well, we want to say, as always, we thank you all for this invite to be able to fellowship with you all tonight. We bring you greetings from the Cummins You Are Ministries, and we want you all to know that we, again, thank you for thinking enough of us. This little old Mississippi boy, we thank you all for thinking enough of us to allow us to come and share and fellowship with you all tonight. Just like my dad just said, he was on live. I'm on Facebook Live right along with him. And we're doing live on our page, and we got YouTube going and everything. So we are sharing all over the place tonight. So we thank you again, and we're going to get right into what God has for us tonight. We're looking at Romans chapter 8 and verse 28. Just one verse. Romans chapter 8 and verse 28. Very familiar scripture, and it says that we know that all things work together for the good of them that love the Lord and are called according to his purpose. We thank the Lord for his word, and may the Lord add a blessing to all the readers, hearers, and doers of his holy and divine word. And we're going to talk to you tonight just for a little while from the subject. It's just a setup for a comeback. It's just a setup for a comeback. I listened at all of the testimonies that were shared, and I listened at how everyone was saying we went through this year, we dealt with that this year, but I need you to understand all of that is going to work for you. All of that was just a setup for just what God is about to do in your life, or what God is about to bring you into in your life. All you got to do is learn to be patient and trust him and believe him and stand on his word, because he will make everything all right. I've listened and I heard those said, I've been sick, I've been down. But I want you to know that even though we deal with sickness and we go through trials and we go through the tribulations, I need you to understand that we serve a God that has all power in his hand. We serve a God that is a healer, a deliverer. He's a burden bearer. He's a miracle worker, way out of no way. He's our everything. And I want you to know that no matter how bad the situation looks, no matter how uneasy it may feel, I need you to understand that it's just a setup for your comeback. You say, well, Reverend, I've been dealing with it since last year. I've been dealing with it since the year before, 2019. I was dealing with this same thing, 2020. I was dealing with this, 2021. I'm still dealing with it, but I need you to understand that God is about to bring you into something that you never expected. God is about to take you to a place that you never thought you would be able to go. Even though we understand and know that sometimes it takes a little while. Things are not always work in our timing. It works in God's timing. So we have to learn to be patient and move when God said move and do what he's telling us to do. Because Psalms 30 and 5 said, weeping may endure for a night, but there's some joy coming in the morning. I need you to understand that your blessing is on the way. I need you to understand that your miracle is on the way. I need you to understand that your deliverance is right around the corner. All you got to do is keep doing what I always tell you. Look to the hills from which comes your help, because your help coming from the Lord who made heaven and earth. If you don't believe me, look at Genesis chapter 37 as we talk about our good friend Joseph. And Joseph's story spans over quite a few chapters in the book of Genesis. You look at Genesis 37, Genesis 39, Genesis 40, Genesis 41 through chapter 43, all deal with the life of Joseph. And Joseph was the one that dreamed. Joseph had dreams that God was showing him things and revealing things to Joseph. And he would go and tell his brothers, and his brothers didn't like it. And I need you to understand that everything that God is finna do for you, or everything that God is doing in your life, everybody's not going to understand it. Everybody's not going to accept it. Everybody's not going to like it. So sometimes it's best to just be quiet. Some of y'all need to understand it's just good to just be quiet sometimes. Keep it to yourself and wait till God does what he's about to do. Why? Because people will try to discourage you. People will try to change your mind. People will try to stop you from believing what God is about to do for you. But there's nothing nobody can say or do that would deter me from believing in my God. You can say what you want, do what you want, but I know the God that I serve has all power in his hand. The reason I know it, because I tried it for myself. If you look at Joseph got into a point to where his brothers didn't like him. So what did they do? They threw him into a pit. And Joseph kept going down because he went from the pit to slavery. And from slavery, he was in Potiphar's house. Now, when he got to Potiphar's house, you would have thought that everything was better. He got in Potiphar's house, and Potiphar placed him as ruler over everything in the house. And Potiphar allowed him to be over a lot of stuff, and he trusted Joseph. But while Joseph was in Potiphar's house, Potiphar's wife took a liking to Joseph. And she thought Joseph was real handsome, and she tried Joseph. And Joseph said, look, my master has given me control over everything in his house, but you. I can't fool with you. I can't get on that level with you. But she wasn't going to stop. So one day she tried Joseph again, and she grabbed his coat of many colors, and Joseph shook it off and left it. And when Joseph left it, she lied and told her husband that he tried her. And so they threw him in prison. As you can see, Joseph keep going down. But then, while he was in prison, things got a little bit better. People were coming to him and talking to him, and a lot of folk understood that he could interpret dreams. And so they came to him and was asking him questions about this dream and that dream. And while he was there, a lot of folks do like plenty of us do today. We tell people, I ain't gonna never forget about you. I'ma always be there for you. If you need me, call me. It sounds good in theory. Anything you need, I got your back. Anything you need, I'm right here for you. But when you call them, they don't answer the phone. When you try to go by the house, they don't answer the door. Have I got any help in this house? When you try to get in touch with them, nobody wants to deal with you when that rough time comes. Well, when they got out, they forgot all about Joseph. But Joseph didn't let it discourage him. Joseph knew that God had something in store for him. Joseph knew that God had a blessing that was on the way. So Joseph sat right there, and he waited. Patience is something that a lot of us don't have. Patience is something that a lot of us really don't understand. But sometimes it's good just to be patient. Sometimes it's good to just get you a cup of coffee, sit back, and just wait on it. Wait on him to turn it around. Wait on him to fix it. Wait on him to open that door. Wait on him for the healing. Wait on him for the deliverance. Wait on him for your peace. Wait on him for your joy. Because when it comes, you're going to know it. And when he shows up, he'll show up. Joseph sat there and waited. And finally, Pharaoh had a dream. And when Pharaoh had his dream, that same person that said that I'll never forget about you, God laid Joseph on their heart. And he said, King, I know somebody that can interpret the very dream that you're having. They went and got Joseph out of prison. Joseph came. And when Joseph came to Pharaoh, he interpreted the dream for Pharaoh. And when he interpreted the dream for Pharaoh, Pharaoh got him from prison and appointed him to be governor in Egypt. He moved him from a bottom place to put him at the top. I stopped by to tell you that it's just a setup for your comeback. It was just a setup for Joseph to get to where God was wanting him to be. It was just a setup for God to put Joseph in the place where he would be. Because those same folk that talked about it, them same folk that put him down, them same brothers that tossed him into the pit were the same one that had to come to him when they were in need. They had to come to that same Joseph. Didn't even recognize him. God had blessed him so good. They didn't even recognize Joseph. They didn't even know who he was, but Joseph knew them. And Joseph could have been mean. He could have been spiteful. He could have said to them, you know what? We're not going to give you anything. I'm not going to take care of y'all. Y'all threw me in the pit, had me put into slavery, had me go through all of this. He said, but no, I'm going to bless you anyway. Why? Because this is what God would want me to do. It was just a setup for God to put me right where I needed to be. Well, if you don't understand that story, let me tell you about Job. Job was a man that believed in God, that trusted God. God and Satan had a conversation about old man Job. And then Satan decided that he wanted to do some things to Job to get Job to turn his back on God. God said, that's okay. You can touch him. Just don't touch his soul. He said, well, when I get through with him, he'll give me that. So he took Job through a series of problems. Job lost his family. Job lost his cattle. Job lost all of his riches. He even lost his wife. You say, well, Reverend, how he lose his wife? The woman was still alive. He lost his wife because she came to him. She said, Job, I'm going to bring it up to 2021. Job, I can't live like this. Now, we ain't got no money. Every time I try to go swipe my card, they tell me it's declined. I can't go get Kate Spade no more. I can't go get Michael Kors no more. I can't eat at the fine restaurants we used to eat at no more. My car, they don't repossess it. Joe, I can't live like this no more. Why don't you just curse God and die? Job said, woman, you sound foolish. You don't sound like my wife. Because if you understood and know that the God that we serve, he's the one that blessed us with all of this stuff that we had. He's the one that placed us to where we are. He's the one that brought us from the bottom to the top. And I don't know about nobody else, but just like that rap song say, nothing can stop me. Why? Because I'm on my way up. I'm on my way up to where God wants me to be. I'm on my way up to the blessings that God has for me. I'm on my way up to the things that God has just for me and mine. That's why Job said in 13 and 15, he said, though he slay me, yet will I trust him. He said, no matter what I'm going through, no matter what I'm dealing with, I'm trusting God, I'm believing God. It looks bad, it looks hard, but I know that God will make a way out of no way. And Job said in Job 14, he said this right here, out of all of my appointed time, I'll wait till my change comes. In other words, I'll endure the sickness. I'm going to wait till my change comes. I'm going to endure the fact that I may be dealing with this and I may not have no money, but I'm going to still wait on the Lord. I'm going to wait on the Lord because why? I know that this is just a setup for my comeback. Sometimes you're going to fall down. And just like Donald McClurkin said, we fall down, but we get up. Yeah, you're going to go through some things. Yes, you're going to make some mistakes. Yes, you're going to say some stuff that you shouldn't say. You might get involved with folk that you shouldn't get involved in. But I stopped by to tell you that God will turn that thing around. All you got to do is trust him and believe him. I'm going to tell you a little story about this woman that got to the point to where she wanted to turn her back on God. And she wanted to give up. She said, because it seems like stuff just keeps getting worse and worse in my life. And I'm ready to backslide. So before she finally made the decision to backslide, she said, let me start reflecting. And that's where God stepped in. She said, well, I remember when I was out in the world, I had all the friends I wanted. Anytime I called on somebody, they were right there. Then I got saved and I joined the church and all my friends didn't want to have nothing to do with me no more. Then when I was in need, I couldn't pick up the phone and call nobody. Then when I was hungry, I couldn't get nobody to feed me. I don't know why I got saved in the first place. It seems like I got more problems now than I had before. But at the end of the day, she kept sitting there reflecting and believing. She kept sitting there thinking. And the more she kept thinking, she said, well, wait a minute. Lord, I remember that when I lost my job, you blessed me with another job. Lord, I remember that when I almost got evicted, you blessed me and my family to still have a roof over our head. I remember when they came to repo my car and the man that came to repo it was so nice to give me a little bit more time to pay on the bill. I remember that when they were about to cut my lights off, some way, somehow, you made a way out of no way. I thank you, Lord. I thank you. And the more she began to thank him, she realized I can't turn my back on him. I know that he's been too good and he's been too kind. Well, I need y'all to understand something. God will make a way out of no way. All you got to do is continue to trust him. I know you're going through. I know 2021 been a rough year. I know it seems like you're not going to get out. Sometimes it seems like that you're so sick that you'll never get well. But I stopped by to tell you the only reason why you're going through, God is just setting you up for a comeback. That bad relationship you got out of this year was just a setup for God to bless you with a better one. That crazy job that let you go was just a setup for God to open the door to bless you with a better job. That bad report you got from the doctor was just a setup for God to show his healing power in your life. God is about to turn some stuff around for you. And I don't know about nobody else, but I'm ready to march on into this new year trusting and believing that God will make a way out of no way. Well, church, the clock on the wall says that's all. It's been real fun, but Rev McNeil got to run. See you later, alligator. And after a while, crocodile. But daddy, I believe I go ahead on and preach the same just how I feel. Because see, there were some times in my life where I wanted to give up and times in my life where I wanted to throw in the towel and say, Lord, I just can't do it no more. My health is failing. This is going on. That is going on. People don't want to talk to me no more. Folk don't want to be around me no more. The haters, the caters, and the debaters are talking about me. But I learned that the more I kept calling on him, he showed up and showed out. He helped me to realize that, you know what, son? This is just a setup for your comeback. Don't worry about it. Don't give in to it. Just keep holding on to mind-changing hand. Why? Because I will turn everything around for you. All you got to do is just keep looking to the hill from which cometh your help, because all of your help come from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. So I need y'all to understand that God's got your back. God will take care of you. He will fix your situation. He will open doors for you. Thank you once again for allowing us to share with you all on this New Year's Eve night. And I need you to know God has a blessing with your name on it. God bless you.